Three, two, one. Oh dear. Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the backyard. Today we've got a fun experiment that we're going to try thanks to the suggestion of YouTube user Robert Vipperman. Robert wanted to know what would happen if we mixed molten salt with either liquid nitrogen or dry ice. Well, today is not the day for the liquid nitrogen test, but it is the day to see what happens if we pour molten salt onto dry ice. Well, we've got our foundry, we've got our salt, and we've got some dry ice. Let's try mixing them together. Now, as a first step, what we want to try and do is clean out our crucible. All of the crucibles we've got currently have residue from other projects in them. This one seems to have quite a bit of aluminum built up on the sides. So we're gonna try and chip out what we can, then fire up the foundry and see if we can melt out the rest and shake it out so we have a mostly clean crucible to melt our salt in. We do want a small reservoir in our dry ice to pour the salt into so it doesn't just scatter all over the place. So let's take our drill bit and try and carve a hole down into the ice just a little bit. That looks toasty. See how well molten salt pours out of a crucible. Huh. Well, it's cooled down. It certainly bubbled a good amount, but it didn't react horrendously violently at all, at least not yet. I guess it's still possible to get there, but even the salt that's just on our pavers has cooled down to being solid. Looks like our salt inside our dry ice has as well. Let's see if we can tip that out. Well, there you go, a nice solid chunk of salt right there. I think the salt in our crucible is still liquid. Let's try pouring a little bit more in. I'm skimming some of this aluminum off the top. It's just melting more aluminum as it goes. Whew. I certainly wouldn't want to get that on me, but it's nowhere near the violent kind of reaction that we've seen in other people's channels where they pour salt into water. Ooh, the middle of that is still squishy. Definitely hasn't cooled down all the way. Very hot. Also very hot. Still both very hot. All right, now I know this is probably filled with aluminum and some other trace metals, but I'm gonna lick it. Surprise of all surprises. It's salty. All right, now this is finally cold. That one's a little less cold, but it's also a little bit thicker, and it was poured second, so that makes sense. Now, I'm gonna try and break a piece off of this dry ice. We're gonna see what happens if we drop this dry ice into some molten salt. Let's find out. Three, two, one. Bubbling, bubbling, bubbling. Kind of, not even a lot. Just a little bit of bubbling. I think the dry ice is disappearing a little bit faster than if you just left it out. Not a lot. Oh, one of our pucks broke in half. That's kind of cool. It's got a very smooth outside, but you can see that the crystalline structure has begun to form on the inside as it cooled off. Let's hit this with a hammer. See what happens. Exploded. Now it's rock salt. We've got two more experiments that we want to try, and we've moved to the dome just in case things get out of hand, which I don't think will be a problem, but better safe than sorry. So let's melt up some more salt and then try our next experiment. Because I'm not really sure how this is going to react when it's going down into the crucible, I have a plan for how to dip it in there and keep myself a little ways away. I'll take the dry ice and secure it in a pair of tongs, and then I'm gonna use this extended grabber thing to hold the tongs away from myself, and I'll dip that down into the crucible. I don't really think it's going to explode because neither the dry ice nor the salt will vaporize rapidly the same way normal ice would, but it is possible that some salt will cool down around the dry ice, form a shell, and then the expanding dry ice will cause that to break open. So I do want to stay a little bit away, and that's why I'm not just gonna be dipping this directly down into the salt. Ready? Ooh, well, it's certainly bubbling well. It's quite a bit more of a reaction than I thought we would get, actually. It's spilling all over our container. Starting to slow down. Ooh, there it is. It's now just floating on the top of the salt. My tongs have become salted together. There's just so much salt that built up on the tips. And then it was in contact with the dry ice, so I think it just made it cool down. It's like a salt weld. That was pretty fun. We got a lot more bubbling action than I really thought. The last thing we want to try is to take our salt and then pour it onto a container full of broken up dry ice. So it's not just pouring it onto one flat piece of dry ice that has a hole bored into it. In this case, there's just going to be lots of pieces, and it's just going to flow all over all of it. All right, here we go. I'll take the crucible. I'm just gonna pour it all over that dry ice. This could be exciting. Ready? 3, 2, 1. I think I expected a little bit more of a reaction when that poured on. The salt poured all over chunks of dry ice didn't react a whole lot. We got much more of a reaction when we put it into this solid piece of dry ice that had a hole bored down into it. We got a lot of bubbling and popping, and it did stay in that chunk of dry ice and ended up casting that puck. I thought that was pretty neat. Molten salt versus dry ice. The molten salt didn't react terribly violently, but it did bubble and splash quite a bit, and it's just interesting to see salt as a liquid. It pours very smoothly. It's a pretty runny, thin liquid too. Like, it doesn't turn into a consistency like syrup or anything like that. It's almost as thin as water, it seems. Overall, this is pretty fun. Thank you to Robert for your suggestion of what we should do. Check your YouTube inbox. We're gonna be sending you 25 bucks. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you're not a subscriber yet, just hit the bomb to get in the club. If you missed our last video or want to see it again, click up here at the top. Click down there if you want to see what the internet thinks that you should watch next. That's it for now. Have fun, be safe, and see you tomorrow.